I have lived a very normal life. Since my 20s, I haven't had to deal with the distractions that come from being able-bodied. I've led a life of the mind. Stem cells may give you that same freedom, allowing you to pursue
your wildest dreams without ever having to worry about the limitations of your body. Dr. Robert Lanza is one of the pioneers of stem cell therapies. He is already using them to help patients regenerate damaged body parts.
Right now we're in clinical trials to try to treat blindness using retinal cells that we've generated from stem cells. We've also been able to create entire tubes of red blood cells that transport oxygen just like normal transfusible blood.
Robert's work developed from studying how stem cells create not just body parts, but entire bodies. They do this for all of us when we start out as nothing more than a fertilized egg floating in the womb.
So imagine I'm floating down the fallopian tube. And first there's one of me, and then there's two of me. And there's going to be four of me and eight of me, and we continue on dividing. And eventually, when I get downstream, I'll be a ball of about 100 cells.
These embryonic stem cells are blank cells. They have not yet become a specific type of tissue. But soon, they start transforming into specialized bone cells, muscle cells, and nerve cells. 9 months later, they form a complete person. Once we are born, however, these blank embryonic stem cells disappear. We lose the power that they alone possess to regenerate all of the tissues in our bodies. Robert is working on restoring that power.
So when you think of a regular cell, whether it's a skin cell, a hot cell, or a blood cell, it turns out that that cell carries out a very specific function, and it carries out that function for its entire life. So the question is, what tells that cell what to do? And that's where DNA comes in.
The way DNA is packed into the nucleus of each cell determines what function it's going to have. DNA's long double helix is wound around a huge number of tiny molecular balls in a structure called chromatin. As we grow in the womb, certain proteins interact with the chromatin of a blank embryonic cell, causing parts of its DNA to become unspooled. The parts that are unspooled determine the type of cell this is going to be. A heart cell will have one DNA arrangement, a skin cell another.